Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, Miss Mary Skelton, the cashier, was in love. She was in love with her boss, that larger-than-life cook and character, Jean-Pierre O'Higgins. People do many things for love. They commit suicide. They leave home. Sometimes they simply pine away. But it was for love that Miss Mary Skelton caused a live mouse to be served up in the Maison Jean-Pierre after having paid the station waiter a considerable sum to perform the trick. She it was who wanted to ruin the restaurant so that my client's vengeful wife, Simon, should get nothing out of it.
Mr. Rumpole.
But my client knew nothing of this dire plot. He was entirely innocent.
Mr. Rumpole, if a restaurant serves unhygienic food, the proprietor is guilty in law.
You are not concerned with the law, members of the jury. You are concerned with justice.
That is a quite outrageous thing to say. On the admitted facts of this case, Mr. O'Higgins is clearly guilty.
No British judge has the power to direct a British jury to find a defendant guilty.
I warn you, Mr. Rumpole, I shall tell the jury that he is guilty in law.
His Honor may tell you that to his heart's content. What you do, members of the jury, is a matter between God and your consciences. Can you, in all conscience, find a man guilty and condemn him to ruin when he was as free of criminal intent and conspiracy as the innocent little mouse itself? Can any of you? Can you? The facts of the matter in this case are in your hands and your hands alone, members of the jury. My task is done. The future of that great maître de cuisine, Jean-Pierre O'Higgins, is in your hands and your hands alone.